Good morning, Padres!
Howdy, y'all!
My name's Zach.
I'm Stack.
And this is the Friday Show.
Hit the intro, Sam.
And we're back.
Student drivers, please slow down. We've had reports of students driving at high speeds down the frontage road and almost hitting students walking to school. You're expected to drive slowly both on and off campus. Come on, guys.
The recycling bins on campus have been covered for the time being because students have not been paying attention and the bins are being filled with non-recyclable trash. Use the right bins for your trash and recyclables, Padres. Come on. Also, at lunch, students will be collecting compost from your lunches, so make sure to watch out for them.
Applications for student council positions for next school year are available on my school. Please turn in the intent to apply to Mrs. Powers box. Paperwork can be picked up in your English or social studies classes from Mrs. Powers or on my school.
Attention, all students that park on Flanders. The CHP has advised us that if you park in the wrong direction, that is against the flow of traffic, you will be towed. Park on the right side of the street. Get your act together, Padres.
Are you guys getting ready for prom? Paperwork will be coming out this Friday. Be on the lookout for it. Need a prom ticket? Buy one from the ASB office right now. There are only 300 tickets, and when they're gone, prom is full.
All right, I think it's time for our very first segment, introducing CHS puns made by our very own Sam Boone. Enjoy, folks.
Hey, Padres, we know studying for finals can be hard.
So just listen to these jokes that we made just for you.
One rule of grammar, guys, double negatives are a no-no.
Students who fail their art exams always need a shoulder to cry on. Get it?
Whenever Deckelman's at a singer-songwriter show, you can always tell he's got that algorithm.
When I was a sophomore, I didn't understand math, so Miss Roberts summed it up for me.
Hey, dude, what you got in your lunch? Looks like you have, like, those little red, like, dried fruits with the... What is that, a video camera?
Oh, those are just my... Cranberries!
Hey, Sam, do you think we have any more time left?
I think we have just a little bit left.
All right, well, then it's time to move on...
To the quick fail!
You think we have a little bit more time left?
Wow. Thank you very much for that, Sam. Those puns were very interesting. A true mark of excellent craftsmanship.
Indeed. Attention, robotics team members. There is a meeting in room 40 at lunch for all students attending next week's competition at San Jose State University.
Knows the extent of the damage because not many people know there's even a bridge where it is. So the Fetcher Bridge pretty much connects civilization to Big Sur, and the bridge pretty much is like in the heart of Big Sur. So when people say like 500 people have been affected, that's legit. Like that's literally everyone in Big Sur that's been affected, because that's pretty much by the post office, and where the post office is like the heart of Big Sur. So it's right before the post office coming from Carmel. So it's definitely many people affected, including myself and my family. I haven't seen my family in over a month and a half, so I've been living on my own with some family friends. Well, my family, we've been able to use a helicopter to give my parents food and necessities, but not many people have been that fortunate, and so they made a for now they're working on a trail that they've been building around the bottom of the bridge to kind of let locals get in and out so they can at least go to town and get groceries. But, and they also just opened the south side, which was also closed off, which pretty much isolated everybody as well. But now they opened that side, so now there's a possibility to get around to Big Sur from the other side. But going from Carmel to Big Sur now would take you around 5 hours if you're going to take the south side. So they completely tore down the bridge the other day, so there's no more bridge. And they're going to start rebuilding it, and it's going to take about a year. So we'll see how that changes things.
So what this Club Saves Lives is trying to do is we're going to start selling Pura Vida friendship bracelets every day at lunch in front of Miss Vida's office. So they each cost $3. With the money that we attain from this fundraiser, we're going to then go and buy Safeway gift cards and gas gift cards, anything that's really going to help a family that has been displaced by the bridge. Everything helps, and everybody in Big Sur would appreciate it as well.
Community service news. If you want to be considered for the Presidential Service Award, make sure to have your hours submitted to Ms. Vida by the end of March. That's coming up, so get your hours in.
Additionally, the Carmel Valley Youth Center is accepting applications for summer jobs and community service opportunities. Available jobs include a swim instructor, a lifeguard, a front desk cashier, and facilities maintenance. If that sounds like you, please visit the online bulletin for the link to apply. Ow! Is that a Nerf gun? Ow!
Speaking about Nerf guns, here's a segment about what you've been waiting for all year, Assassins.
So, Assassins is a game where seniors run around with Nerf guns trying to shoot each other.
Hi, my name is Jenna. I'm a senior playing Assassins, and let's see, I killed my target on the first night.
So my job falls along the lines of picking who everyone has to kill.
Alright, it's that time of the day. It's time for birthdays.
Birthdays. Sorry if I butcher your names, guys, but today we wish a happy birthday to Lauren Leach.
And over the weekend to Priscilla Cabrillo, Jacob Cohen, and TJ Solinger. Happy birthday.
And that's it for today, folks.
Thanks for tuning in. I'm Stack.
I'm Zach. And thanks for tuning in to
the Friday Show.